This coverage of MWC is brought to you by Bitdefender Mobile Security. Lenovo's 10-inch tablet has been updated with a better screen, a better processor, and it retains its own signature style. It's Joshua Vergara from Android Authority. What's going on, everybody? And this is the Lenovo Yoga Tablet 10 HD Plus. The original Yoga tablet took a page out of the Yoga line of laptops in that it wanted to take mobility to a different level. Many Android tablets these days are black slates or large slabs that require a third-party accessory or some sort of apparatus to make it stand up on its own. Lenovo sought to fix this issue by creating a tablet that was not only sleek but included its own solution to this problem. Enter the Yoga Tablet 10, which sported a more enlarged lower portion that housed not only a larger battery for better longevity, but also a sturdy stand that allowed the tablet to be used in a couple different but very practical positions. As far as the tablet itself goes, we have a 10-inch screen that this time around has been brought up to full HD at 1920 by 1200 resolution. While much of what comes out of the screen looks quite good, I would argue that the colors do look a little washed out at times and could use a little more fidelity all around. A nice metallic finish adorns this entire tablet, making the device feel very sturdy and of a premium quality. It also is pretty incredibly thin, until you get to the stand and battery portion, of course, as the thinnest part of the tablet gets to just around 3 millimeters thick. For a 10-inch tablet, it sure doesn't feel like it takes up too much space. It's not hard to maneuver the tablet in your hands, and it's not hard to keep it steady in one hand, especially if you use it in portrait mode and take advantage of the leverage provided by the thicker portion. Underneath the surface are some more updates, especially when considering the processing package. The original Yoga Tablet 10 sported a MTK chipset, but this time around, the Snapdragon 400 has been employed to bring solid performance. 2GB of RAM and 32GB of onboard storage are also available. As we have alluded to, the large battery, the 9,000 mAh unit does provide up to 18 hours of battery life as per Lenovo's claims, and it should go for quite a while until it needs a charge. Now, Lenovo's UI does try to keep things as stock as it can, but it may not impress too many users out there as it does do away with the app drawer, and thus you can get your home screens riddled with icons and widgets if left unorganized. It also doesn't seem to be completely optimized, at least from my standpoint, as it lacks the snappiness of plenty of other user interfaces, much less more stock-like offerings. But in the end, what really differentiates this tablet is its mobility. With a stand built in, you can use the tablet as a simple viewing apparatus or angled up for easier typing and manipulation. It's one of those features you don't realize you really wanted until it's finally provided to you, and that is what makes the Yoga Tablet pretty special. We'll see the Yoga Tablet 10 HD Plus in the market towards the middle part of this year. So keep it tuned to Android Authority as we continue to bring you all of the best coverage from the Mobile World Congress here in Barcelona, Spain.